A very good evening and welcome to the newsroom this Saturday. This is the Celebrity Edition, just like we do every weekend. And tonight we're joined by international hip-hop star
Navio, right here on the newsroom.
Let's jump right away with a look at the top stories on TNR tonight. Muslim murders, Tabligh's call for international community involvement.
Two dilapidated business centers closed in Kampala.
All taxi park kiosks erased as traders remain stranded.
Unemployed youth advised to try farming.
And as Makerere closes its 65th graduation, will fresh graduates add to corruption cancer? Welcome to TNR once again. In our top story, the Tabligh Muslim community has urged the government to involve the international community in the investigation process into the recent Muslim murders. The call was made by the acting Amiru Umar Sheikh Yahya Mwanje during a meeting at their Nakasero Mosque.
As police continues to arrest more Muslim leaders, the acting Amir Umar of the Tabligh says government should involve the international community to speed up investigations. So far, over 10 Muslim clerics have been arrested following the mysterious Muslim killings that have left several leaders of Muslim sects dead since last year. Sheikh Yahya Mwanje insists they are not against the government's approach, but want international community to get involved in the investigation process. The story was filed by Jaliat Namwaya for TNR.
Quite a pity. You never know where bad things are going to happen. Apologies to the people of Nakasero. On our second story, two business centers closed in Kampala. Two business centers in Kampala have been closed as KCCA moves to close all dilapidated buildings within the city. The operation is expected to affect over 50 buildings, according to KCCA's physical planner, Stephen Ojok.
Business owners who are housed at Kalunji and Plot House De Winton Road were left stranded as KCCA operationalized the closure of dilapidated buildings. According to KCCA, all buildings in the city should have a new look, which include pedestrian walkways on the outside as well as beautiful through paintings. When you clearly look at this building on Plot 1, De Winton Road, you notice that it's too dilapidated. Its painting is worn out, but this is not the only one in such a state. A walk through the city will bring you a clear picture. But according to KCCA, such buildings will be no more, even as tenants insist they were not informed.
We have notified them. A number of them have complied, but some haven't yet. And it is upon this basis that today we came at De Winton and took the action you saw of sealing off the building until when those nuisances are abated.
The building owners have, however, accused KCCA of making the renovation process difficult. Report compiled by Jaliat Namuwaya.
The ongoing KCCA demolitions of illegal structures in the old taxi park kicked off at 2 a.m. and left over 70 kiosks demolished because of poor sanitation. The traders were earlier given a 28-day notice and an extra 3 months to vacate this place for better development.
At the old park, there are over 70 kiosks, illegal structures which include eateries, phone accessory outlets, soft drink kiosks, among others, which KCCA says were set up without any permit from KCCA. The traders were, however, given chance to get their merchandise out of these illegal structures. On 29th of September 2014, KCCA issued a notice to all traders around the old taxi park, informing them that these kiosks were set up illegally. Although some traders removed their merchandise, others refused and their businesses were thrown away by KCCA enforcement officials. Some traders said that they were alert of this operation and decided to take away their merchandise as they wait for the development.
Kirungi nyo okulaba ekibuga Capital City okulaba nga mulimu ebintu nga bino babijemu ensekule.
The Disabled Traders Associations, who have been operating in the old taxi park, have asked KCCA to process their lease as soon as possible.
People's disabilities, they have nowhere to go, so we are just appealing the government if it can just process our lease so that at least we develop our title, our land.
KCCA Director of Operations Rusoke Chituma said that traders were issued several warnings before this exercise and some extra 3 months.
Good enough. They requested for an extension from the executive director of KCCA, which extension was given to 31st December. I came back 3 days back and reminded them that they need to respect the promise they made. So, good enough. As a result, a number of them removed their containers and kiosks. That's why even when we came, we found actually business going on.
Traders were left stranded with nowhere to go. Report compiled by Hasfanan Tali.
Yes, actually, even in South Africa, we've had a few problems with the locals where we've had to clamp down. Yeah, on our fourth story tonight, unemployed youth advised to try farming. A team of youths under the Youth Economic Empowerment Project, YEEP, has come out to encourage fellow youth to join entrepreneurship. More so farming instead of just looking around for jobs that like they never find. The youths say it's a waste of time taking to the streets to demonstrate for lack of jobs. The mushroom farmers assert that entrepreneurship opens many doors that cannot be opened with a begging mentality, and I agree with that for one.
Mayor of Manige, a mushroom farmer and multi-award winner, scoffs at youths who pride in being unemployed and even take to the streets to demonstrate. She encourages the youth to join entrepreneurship, for it is what has brought her to where she is now. Manige was named one of Africa's top 30 entrepreneurs.
Test this project, and testing the project, they are looking at innovative way of how we can turn the garbage. The garbage we are looking at are the kitchen wastes, the agricultural wastes from the market. Those are like maybe bean husks, whatever that comes into the market, and also these polythenes, because we are looking at how we've collect these polythenes and make them as columns for planting the mushrooms. The plastics, instead of using again the polythenes, they as baggings, you can use them as hang lines for tying these gardens, and also use these plastic bottles.
She adds that mushroom farming does not require a lot of starter capital, since lack of enough funds is the major challenge that willing entrepreneurs face.
That doesn't require capital, that is the fact. But all business is what I believe to, you have to begin small. With a little you have, you can be able to start up a project. When I give an example of the mushroom, if I have my wastes available, meaning the only capital I have is for the seed, or what we call in a mushroom language, the spawn. And maybe the only man I'll need for the spawn, it can be maybe like 30,000, which can give me 20. Of which, when you look at 30,000, that is the money people have, but they look it as if it cannot start anything. But I say you can begin small and then you grow.
Fred Baseke, a youth entrepreneur, reasoned that one of the factors causing the shilling to weaken against the dollar is the fall of export of agriculture products. He advised the youth not to sell land back in villages simply to attain quick money, but to use it for farming. Baseke adds that they have worked together with government to change the entrepreneurship curriculum in high school to ensure that more teachers and students attain vocational skills to be used outside school.
And the young people who out there who have graduated the message is you don't despise the jobs. Don't think that you don't wait for the job in the profession that you have graduated in. Just take up anything. That's why we advocate for entrepreneurship. Entrepreneurship is about creativity. It's about having new ideas. It's about opportunity seeking. Where there's a challenge for you, you seek an opportunity.
The project is to provide a platform for former street vendors who were evicted by KCCA to invest better. Baseke says the eviction of street vendors should not be criticized because it's for the betterment of Uganda, though he acknowledges the challenges it brings to the vendors. One of the youth farmers notes a general negative attitude towards farming, not only among the youth, but also the old part of society.
Yes, I've been able to drive a vehicle from nothing but other than farming. And I met quite a number of friends from Netherlands, from US, from South Africa because of farming. But I encourage the youth, all the youth, not to train agriculture, to come and enjoy agriculture because it's the only source of...
Report by Amelia Matha Nachitimbo for TNR.
Well, of course, that's better advice than painting pigs yellow and taking to the streets to demonstrate. Moving on, an 18-month-old child on Friday evening drowned in a lagoon used to drain waste of Waraji as police blames parents for negligence. Police spokesperson Fred Enanga said it's a criminal offence which will be charged with rash and negligent action.
And it really is just a complete tragedy. On our sixth story today, the Kampala series. Tonight on our TNR series, Daniel Mumbarai continues with changing the faces of entertainment scene. It's sort of one of those things that the Australians have been known to do as well from time to time.
Kampala has always had a vibrant nightlife attributed to the party-loving nature of its residents. While in the colonial times, most of the night spots were strictly for whites, after independence in 1962, places like City Bar on Kampala Road, Susanna in Nakulabye, DV8 on Wilson Road, and the Kololo Club in Industrial Area were among the famous hangouts for the city's party animals. Over the years, the party spirit of Kampala's people has held steadfast as a staple of Kampala city. The bars, nightclubs and hotels where the people party have however become bigger and better in the spirit of embracing modernity and development. The present-day club governor in Industrial Area is the perfect demonstration of how these establishments have evolved over the years to embrace the changing times. The club that now opens 2 days a week has gone through several phases as Ange Mystique in 2002, Club Ange Noir Discotheque in the 90s, Ange Noir in the 80s, and Kololo Nightclub before 1986. Size has also been a distinguishing factor in the way nightclubs have operated in Kampala. The recently opened Ambience nightclub in Bukesa, Bakuri, is the best demonstration of how the nightlife has become even more vibrant, calling for bigger and more spots to accommodate the residents of the city. The club that was launched in July last year has laid claim to the title of the biggest nightclub in East Africa. Concerts are another major highlight of Kampala's nightlife, and over the years, the city has hosted mega concerts featuring the best of local and international music acts. But the KCCA directive to have all concerts hosted in the city end at midnight is threatening this concert-going culture. While in the past, Kampala residents partied all night with their favorite artists at joints like Lugogo Cricket Oval and Chadodo Rugby Grounds, today the artists have resorted to venues outside the city like Freedom City in Najanankumbi and the National Stadium in Nambole.
So what I'm going to give you tonight is some good music, yeah? Much love to the people out there. Watch this. See ya.
And as we wrap up our series on the changing faces of Kampala, the question of whether Kampalans will still be able to party in the city still hangs in the air. Will Kampala residents adjust to the parties that end at midnight, or will the city's party scene be permanently moved to outside the city?
You're watching TNR. This is the Celebrity Edition. We're joined by Navio tonight. Let's have a quick recap of tonight's top stories for you. Muslim murders, Tabliq's call for international community involvement in investigations.
Two dilapidated business centers closed in Kampala.
All taxi park kiosks erased as traders remain stranded.
Unemployed youth advised to try farming.
And as Makerere closes its 65th graduation, will fresh graduates add to corruption cancer? You're watching DNR, my friend. We are joined with Navio.
Absolutely.
I just can't keep up with you.
Yes.
How many accents can you do?
I don't know. I guess we've done about 4 or 5.
Yes.
Yeah, maybe a few more. I travel a lot. So I think, yeah, that's why I pick up the accents.
Okay. All right. So how's your career going so far? 2015.
2015. So far, so good. I mean, we've had a pretty successful year. More in terms of endorsements than anything else. You know, everything from the Twende Kazi project to the C Studio project to, you know, being on an energy conservation project. You know, there's so many little endorsement deals and things that we did last year.
You seem to have so much money to throw around. I mean, you're shooting videos in South Africa and stuff.
Well, I wouldn't say to throw around, you know, but I do believe in putting money back into my art form.
Okay.
You know, but yeah, this year is definitely going to be all about the music.
Okay.
You know, I think I've kind of been out of the limelight for long enough, and it's time to come back hard to the charts. So that's the plan.
We're with Navio on TNR. This is Celebrity Edition. Let's take a break. We'll be back with sports.